ceremony, we call this day as Sangha Day. Sangha, you know, monks, actually, when we say monks, there are few categories. Sangha, Bhikkhu Sangha, when we say Sangha, Bhikkhu Sangha, then we can say Bhikkhuni Sangha. At least there are two sections. When a male person ordained, we call monk. When we have a group of monks, we call Sangha. Sangha means group. Then when a lady ordained, we call Bhikkhuni. When they have a group also, we call Bhikkhuni Sangha. Generally, when we say Sangha, Bhikkhu Sangha and Bhikkhuni Sangha, these two groups are included. And Sangha, that means Venerable Mahasangha. If I say Buddhist Mahasangha, started during the Buddha's time, that means more than 25 centuries ago. And they are wearing almost similar robe. Of course, you can see we have Venerables belong to different traditions. They are wearing some different robes. Even that, similarity is there. In that way, we can say this is the oldest uniform in the world. And monks are wearing this without much changes up to today, that means nearly 25 centuries. And it has many meanings. Symbolically, the robe gives many meanings. You may have heard before also, especially robe symbolically gives a meaning, maturity, color. When leaves of a tree, if not some fruits, when they are ripened, the color change to orange. Of course, we can't find all the robes are orange here. There are some robes different color, but originated in the same way. So when leaves are ripened or fruits are ripened, they give orange color, change to orange color. That means ripened, matured, maturity. It doesn't mean all of us are very matured monks. Don't misunderstand. We also make mistakes. We are trying to be matured by practicing teachings of the Buddha. We are highly committed to achieve maturity. What is maturity? Highest maturity is Buddhahood, enlightenment, becoming a Buddha. Buddha is the person who attained the highest maturity. So we are almost fully committed to achieve that goal. Of course, all the Buddhists are committed to achieve that, but you are not totally committed because you have so many other commitments. We have given up many commitments and try to have total commitment towards the goal shown by the Buddha. Practice teachings of the Buddha and achieve that goal. is merely symbolical value of the robe. So today you ask after a wife going to offer that robe and reminding us, Venerable Sirs, you all have to remember, you all have committed to practice the Dhamma to attain total maturity. Not only that, you all are reminding us, all the monks, you all have committed to show us the way to attain maturity according to the way shown by the Buddha. So, if we can think in that way, if we both parties can think in that way, this robe suffering can be very meaningful. It is not just something nice and offered to us. So when we have nice robes, new robes we wear, these are general things. But the meaning behind, one of the meanings behind is very important. On the other hand, don't forget, there is another important symbolical value of the robe. That is impermanence. When we study or learn about essence of Buddhism, first thing we learn is anicca or impermanence. It reminds us about the impermanence also. Actually, we monks should be the people who has to remember impermanence all the time. They should not forget about that. We should not forget about that impermanence. Why do we have to remember about the impermanence? Remembering impermanence helps us to maintain our principles. I think you all know a monk who received higher ordination and committed to practice. Worried to make a mistake. 227 principles. Of course, most of principles, I have to be honest with you, we can forget about that. But very serious and important principles. When we remember and follow those important principles, other ordinary principles, or automatically followed. So I don't want to go to details to talk about principles of monks, but we have many. Because we have to give you some examples, we have to lead an exemplary life. So our behavior, talking, walking. But sometimes I walk very fast. When people go with me, they worry. They come after me and say, "Bhante, slowly, slowly." Something I have difficulties to do. Anyway, when we walk, when we talk, when we eat, for everything, all these things, we have some principles. We have some guidelines. We have to practice. So, in order to practice all these principles and lead a good life, means right life of a monk, we must remember something which is very important, that is impermanence. If we know we are impermanent, very difficult for us to do wrong things. That's not only for monks, actually good for you all also. Some people work so hard to gain more and more. If certain people even do evil things to have a comfortable material progress, in the end they get old and have to leave the world. Until that day, they don't know about the impermanence. So we have to remember this. So this yellow robe reminds us we are impermanent. Whole world is impermanent, so it is is not that we have to stop everything and cry, thinking we are impermanent. We have to work harder. We have to pay more attention towards our work, but in a righteous way. So there is another meaning of the yellow or orange color robe. If I go to tell these things, there are many other things, but I have to think of the time also. We monks used to chant blessing sutras. We use another word called protection sutras. Main purpose of chanting paritta, so sutras, paritta sutras, is blessing for people or protection of people. Meaning of paritta sutras is actually protection. So we call paritta is arakha paritta. Arakha means protection. We do it. That is one of our duties. But that is not the only purpose of monk's work. We have to teach people. We have to help people to understand the Dhamma. That is another duty. So, monks have to perform many duties for the benefit of people. Therefore, we have one day in a year, at least once a year, offering things to monks to show lay people's appreciation towards the monk. They are supposed to do chanting of protection sutras. They are supposed to teach the Dhamma and guide us. So they do that kind of services towards people. So in return, lay people have to appreciate their kind work and show their appreciation. In other words, they have to do thanksgiving. So today is, in a way, I can say, Thanksgiving Day of lay people towards the monk. So that's why you all are carrying robes and wreath. On the other hand, we don't receive your presents or presenting robes without any thoughts. When you offer, we always think of your good health, happiness, and spiritual progress. So with love and compassion, we try our very best to receive your offerings. So when we go on and on saying these things, we can see the robes offering day is not just offering day of something monks collect and go. There are many meanings, many valuable meanings behind this. So today we are doing such a valuable ceremony by offering robes. Then there are books also. This is very unique for the Buddhist Library. One of the important activities of the library. The same day we encourage people to offer books, because library is a place with books. Anyway, I feel a bit sad. Nowadays people are getting lazier and lazier to read books. The thing is, they are hooked to other kind of gadgets. So they are very keen about selfies, they are very keen about reading things online. But I feel that when you do that, you are not very serious. When you want to read the book, you take the book, go somewhere, sit nicely and read, your attention is better. But people think now no need to remember anything, online we can find everything. Because of that, books are dying now. People don't want to read much. than this, we say reading make a person wise, intelligent, perfect, but now we have forgotten about that. But I think still it is good to read books. You can go to all those things, but remember, reading books is also very important. Don't neglect it. Keep that habit. Don't let that habit die. It will bring many negative results to our life. So we have book presentation also on this occasion. Some of our members are waiting to offer books. I appreciate offering books more than robes. Robes has a symbolic value. Books can give quite direct wisdom to people if people read mindfully. So that's all I want to say. And I am very thankful to you for taking trouble to come here, gather, squeeze inside for a while to do the offering. Now I will hand over this to our president. Once again, thank you.
So now I'd like to